I'm Anindya from the Enkidu team, and I'm here to address some of the more commonly occurring questions in our community. Right now, Enkidu does not have a competitor in the blockchain space. We are right now the only platform that aims to popularize decentralized collaboration that is completely accountable because it is on the blockchain. The only competition that Enkidu would have is from the Delaware C Corp. Now, when you're investing in an ICO, the most important thing is the white paper, because that is what lucidifies the idea, and the white paper is what sheds insight on how much the team has actually thought about the idea. I would encourage all of you all to please take a look at our white paper. Looking at the panel of advisors that are there is very, very important. For Enkidu, we have Jay Smith of Factum, LDJ Capital's David Drake, and Ian Scarf of Bing Plus on board. Our MVP is already on the way. I've spoken to my tech team and they have assured us that before the end of the week, we shall have a minimum viable product and the code will be released on GitHub to the general public. If we reach our hard cap, we're going to hire the absolute best blockchain developers. We already have some of the best blockchain developers on board. Of course, a large part of the funds will be used for marketing and actually getting freelancers and people who want to work with each other on board our platform so that we can have early adoption. Our target user is the person who would like to collaborate with other people from around the world and earn passive income. Now, passive income is where we don't trade our time for money, right? That's what happens in a company. And the goal of Enkidu is to empower people just like you and me to be able to do that. Participants will get their tokens 2 weeks after the end of the ICO, that is 2 weeks after May 5th. All unsold tokens during the pre-sale will carry over to the actual ICO. And tokens, if at all unsold during the ICO, they go back to the company reserve. Now, the company reserve is not the number of tokens that are in possession of the team. The company reserve is the number of tokens that we will be used to build community, to give back to people who can help this platform grow. It is what we use to nurture people and get them onboarding Enkidu and utilize it to its absolute maximum potential. We will have the first beta for Enkidu before the end of the year, and version 1 for both mobile and for desktop will be out by Q1 2019. The Enkidu platform right now is being developed by our expert in-house development team, as well as some experts from Jacobi Ventures who have been working on smart contracts for a while. The entire team of Enkidu has a minimum lock-in period of 6 months. However, every employee of Enkidu has a vesting period of 4 years and they cannot liquidate all their funds before that time. Now, how our employees are going to cash in on Enkidu ultimately is not the ICO. The amount that we raise in the ICO, in fact, is quite small compared to the 0.5% transaction fee that we will be charging on all transactions that happen via the Enkidu payment gateway. So we haven't taken a SaaS model for this. In a SaaS model, typically the company pays a flat fee for the software services that are provided to them. Over here in Enkidu, we are taking a 0.5% transaction fee, which is 1/4 of what traditional payment gateways take. Now, half of this will go to the team, to the Enkidu treasury, and the other half, that is the other 0.25%, will be burned immediately. And this is a measure to keep the value of the ENK token constantly rising with time. Our ultimate aim is to completely replace the Delaware C Corp with Enkidu. Just imagine 0.5% of all the transactions that happen out there for small businesses. That amount is far greater than what we could even aim to reach in our ICO.